Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue Kel'Thuzad week here with the Fissure Combo Burst build, the one that you saw yesterday. I have been practicing it more and more, trying to incorporate Glacial Spike into the combo, because I know that there are variations of the build that heavily revolve around Glacial Spike, and after a couple other games here, I begrudgingly admit that I do think that the Glacial Spike way is the way to go, but that doesn't mean I have to like it. I still maintain the opinion on Glacial Spike that it's too much. It just feels like you're doing too much movement with your fingers on the keyboard in order to make the burst happen. I realize that sort of sounds like lazy, and it's like Invicta doesn't care about high skill cap heroes. That's not true at all, because you're talking to someone who mained as Invoker in Dota 2. So for those of you know what that means, you know exactly what I'm talking about. For Kel'Thuzad, I think that he is potentially the most powerful mage in the game, especially with the combo that he has. If you are able to pull off the full combo, it does more damage than anything else I can think of in the game, other than maybe Pyroblast. And that's sort of the crux of what I want to talk about really quickly, because I know that there's a raging debate going on right now amongst people who are in the know about whether or not Kel'Thuzad is OP or he's not OP, or he's only OP if you make him OP, meaning that if you put in the time to land and to get to the skill cap necessary to make him good, then he might become a little bit OP. So I personally like having a hero in the game that you have to put in a lot of practice with. There is definitely a lot of risk and reward for Kel'Thuzad, and you might be thinking, Invicta, where's the risk? Because all I see is a ranged assassin that can just do a ton of damage from, a pretty decent amount of range. Which is kind of true, but the best damage that Kel'Thuzad can do means that he has to be almost in melee range to land the chains, and more importantly, Frost Nova. Frost Nova is the biggest part of this entire combo, because you have to land that stun, and of course later on at level 16 you get the ability to have a damage increasing debuff on the enemy team that you land on your target, and it's just good. I mean, it just does that. We get an easy quick first kill there on first blood there, I should say, on Leoric. Not really that big of a deal. There's Death and Decay there. Nice job there by ETC as well. Actually getting another kill. By the way, we are on a four stack. It's myself along. I'm playing Odd Man Out up with Jaina, ETC, Zul, and Tyrone. We're going against Alarak, Zul'jin, Abathur, Tracer, and Leoric. So yeah, so going back to Kel'Thuzad, again, I know that there's going to be this perception that he is just way too broken, too OP, etc., etc. And I don't necessarily disagree with that, but again, I think that we are going to see a change in Kel'Thuzad. I think that we are going to see him nerfed, not because necessarily of the combo and how it's played, but more along the lines of Blizzard will probably do the idea that, he's just not fun to play against, or it's not fun to be killed around from 100% to dead within, one combo. And I can certainly understand what they're talking about. That's a big thing that Blizzard's always been really high on, is making sure that their games are fun for people, and that it's not a chore to play against people. They've really tried to do that to Valyra, who I still think is not that much fun to play against. I think that Tracer and Genji would also probably fit those descriptions. But for the most part, I definitely see them doing that to Kel'Thuzad. We have a super tryhard Alarak over here, apparently. I look forward to landing my first Frost Nova over there. Level 4 gonna be going for the Phylactery of Kel'Thuzad. Again, that's gonna be the one where we get when we get ten regen globes. Of course, I don't have the spike right now, so I don't have. I'm doing this out of force of habit. I have really been trying hard to practice the combo, because when you're actually able to pull it off, it is very impressive. I mean, very, very impressive damage. But when you don't, you just kind of feel like a floundering noob. You kind of feel like a Magikarp in a way. And yeah, I just made a Pokemon reference here in Heroes of the Storm. There's Tracer actually able to dodge the chain here. Almost actually got it with Blizzard too. That would have been nice. Gonna back away, and I don't know why I said that so weird. Gonna back away. Should be able to get the kill here on Leoric, which we were able to do. I actually landed the Death and Decay on Zul'jin as well. There we go, take down Tracer. Didn't you have to land the chain there or the Frost Nova? ETC needs to be real careful. We're able to actually get the kill on Zul'jin, which is pretty impressive. Oh, I didn't know that Toronto was going for the Lunar Flare there. We are able to get the first couple of kills. Again, we are playing on a hard 4 stack, so I'm not expecting to... I'm not expecting to really contribute much to the team fights here, but I want to. Again, all this is going to be for good practice. So, the final thing I'll say before we go on any further here in this game is that I do think that we can easily expect to see a change for Kel'Thuzad within the next week. I do anticipate Blizzard pulling the old, you know, oh well, we're going to release a hero that seems really strong or is just really strong, and then we're going to nerf him, you know, a week later. I mean, that's a pattern that they've sort of done over the past couple of years, I guess now. I mean, it's been like at least 10 heroes that they've done that to. So the main combo, talking about this build now that I'm off my soapbox here talking about Kel'Thuzad and the state of Heroes of the Storm, not really, it's just I'm being sarcastic. So the main combo is this. So what you want to do is, before you have Glacial Spike, obviously you want to lead off with your chain. After you get the chain, you can lead off with it, or you can lead off with the spike. It's completely up to you. I was sort of anticipating Tracer actually getting thrown off into the spike there. Gonna land my D&D here, or not. I was not able to get the chain. I am gonna have to go back away and tap the fountain real quick. So you want to lead off with the chain. You want to lead off with your E. E is the biggest part of the entire combo to start off with. If you land your chain, if you land the initiation with your chain, things become a lot easier for you to actually land for the rest of the combo. And the idea is simple. You want to use your chain, basically cause them to get a stun whenever you can on either the spike or another teammate, ideally. And then you want to throw down your Frost Nova immediately. And I mean, like, really, really, really immediately. Like, before you cast the rest of the combo here, like this, on Alarak. You saw right there. So what I did, I didn't have to use the spike there. All I needed to do was just land the Chains of Kel'Thuzad on Alarak, waited until I was ready to get in position to throw him into the wall. And before I used my chain, right before I used the second cast on E, I was able to throw down a Frost Nova and keep him locked there. And that's just basically it. Because then you just finish it off with a Shadow Fissure at level 10. And then it's just GG after that. So that's the basic premise of the combo. Now, what's neat about Glacial Spike, of course, is that you do have the luxury of creating an object that will give you something to collide with, something to use your chain on. So if you don't have a wall next to you, or if you need to say something, if you need a peel or someone, or you need to make a peel for yourself, you can do that with a spike. Remember, the spike is a pretty ridiculous amount of cast range that you can use. And on top of that, it also slows targets down whenever you use it. Like right here, we're going to throw down the spike, throw down the chain as well. There's the Frost Nova, but unfortunately, we took just too much damage from Zul'jin. I also sort of skirted the line there. I shouldn't have gotten that close to the line. I should have kept over here. That was me getting a little bit overzealous with the chain there. I was too excited because I had a big golden opportunity and then realized we're not level 10 yet. And head back up top here. Man, I didn't use the phylactery yet, Kel'Thuzad. We only have 7 stacks. You're not that good yet, Pimpin, I promise. I don't know if we can get... can we use the chain on the A-bomb? You cannot. All right. Well, Ten, you're going to go for Shadow Fissure again. This is where everything starts to come together for the combo. So you're talking about E, and then either 2, or E, W, and then E again. And the idea is that you want the chains to pull them into the Frost Nova, and then you use Shadow Fissure to finish the dunk. And that's pretty much it. But getting there and landing the combo in a good spot is that's the hard part. Trying to get away from Alarak here. And thanks, Zul. Appreciate that. So Zul was hitting Alarak, which caused him to counter-strike on me. Had Zul not hit Alarak there, I would have been fine. Because he landed the Bone Prison, but, woo! After 8 minutes, it's 8-8 so far. Died twice, which I'm not too happy about. We're only at 10 style. Usually I'm done with Blake stacks by the 7.5 minute mark here. And I'm also just carefully looking around for Abathur, because Abathur's controlling the monstrosity. We know that he is he's not moving right now. There we go. So there's the combo. I just barely missed the Shadow Fissure, but it didn't matter. Taranda was there to land the Lunar Flare. I was a little bit late on the Frost Nova, and that's sort of what cost me there. If we can just get an idea where Abathur is on the map, that's all I really need. I'm looking for the Locusts here, and I don't really see them. As the shadow wills. Because you know Abathur is not going to be... He's not going to be moving around right now with that monstrosity he's got. And taking down the monstrosity is going to be pretty important. I'm also going to be looking around, of course. You want to sort of have a better eye with Kel'Thuzad for looking at the minimap, because you want to make sure that you're able to throw down Shadow Fissures. You don't always have to wait for the combo to use Shadow Fissure, by the way. You can certainly use it in any team fight as long as you're able to get a... okay, so Abathur is in the mid somewhere. He's in the middle lane somewhere. That's all we know. I'm not going to go chase the monstrosity here, but getting him down is going to be very important. Nice job by our team getting the kill there on Alarak. Level 13, going to go for Chains of Ice. Chains of Ice is going to give a nice slow anytime I land the chains on two or more enemies. Nice, Tracer, nice. Oh! Unfortunately, I used the Frost Nova a little bit early there. I didn't have it for the combo. That would have been nice, though. See if Tracer ends up getting a little brave here. Again, all you have to do is just land that chain, and the rest is easy. Easier, I should say. Abathur's still in mid. I saw that Locust down there. If Tyrone can give me a, if she can give me a spot on Abathur, then that'd help out a lot. Zul causing Counter-Strike again from Alarak. But hey, at least he died for it this time. There we go, I didn't even have to land the chain there. ...776 damage there on Leoric. Again, need to get the 30 stacks of Blight. I cannot emphasize that enough. Gonna be unkillable, but he's standing in Death and Decay, so down he goes. Nice ETC, beautiful. Trying to save ETC. I don't know why he ended up walking towards Leoric. Almost got him there. I was not expecting Tracer to get there in time. I don't have the spike, unfortunately. We're just going to get taken out. I'm going to go ahead and use the phylactery, come back. But unfortunately, I'm not going to be there in time to use Shadow Fissure to stop them from getting that. Now, we know they're going to be going for the boss, most likely. Considering that none of them died. And after 12 minutes, it's 12 to 14. I'm not exactly sure how I'm number one on XP, but we have died 3 times, which, again, I'm not too happy about. Oh man! Like I said, still needs practice. You have a very limited window of time to land the second chain, because most of the time, unless the enemies are just not paying attention, most of the time they're gonna see it coming from a mile away, and they can sort of guess where you're gonna be throwing out the glacial spike if you have it. Things get a lot easier in a team fight, of course, because you do have the option. You have the luxury of them sort of like being in a little bit of a confusion state. Able to land that on the monstrosity here. This Abathur player is trying real hard to keep his monstrosity relevant here. Level 16, going to go for Hungering Cold. Hungering Cold is going to increase the amount of damage that that enemies take whenever I land them on with Frost Nova. There, I was able to stop Leoric there. Again, we still don't have our 30 stacks of Blight yet. Got the slow. I don't know if I'm going to be... Get Tracer! I'm trying to get the snipe on her. I think Tracer is going to be able to get away, unfortunately. So the enemy team, they were able to get the tribute, which happens. There we go, and there's that debuff that I was talking about that Frost Nova gives. And I'm just going to sit here and try to defend our fort. Though apparently Abathur just does, like, world-ending damage. I don't know if Shadow Fissure actually works on the Monstrosity. I don't think it does. There we go. So we're able to actually save the... we were able to save the fort. I'm okay with. Still looking for the Locust to find out exactly where Abathur is. Duel should have a pretty easy time here with Tracer, maybe. Gonna have to go down to the bot lane and take care of that. Let the curse end. But really right now I'm being hamstrung by the fact that we don't have 30 stacks of Blight, and also dealing with Tracer and Abathur have been it's been a little bit harder than I would have expected. There we go. Zul end up getting the dunk anyway there on Leoric. I'm still gonna try to defend the bot lane here the best I can. The enemy team, they have a lot of lane pushing. They've got a lot of soakers as well. How many times has Leoric died? Leoric has died, he's only died 3 times. Alright. Not too bad. Not too bad. There's the stun there. Not able to get him. Ronda was looking for the snipe with the sentry owl. Didn't happen. Of course, I was not going to go after... I'm not going to go chase after Zul'jin there, not with most of my team being dead. And with the enemy team having level 20, there's not really a whole lot that we can get done in the grand scheme of things. Still have no idea where Abathur is actually located. We see the Monstrosities down in the bot lane. We're going to go ahead and take care of that. Nice shot by Tyrande stopping the deep tunnel there of the Monstrosity. Taking him off the map. We have all... Alright, well, we don't need our entire team taking one Siege Giant camp. The enemy team probably going after their own bosses right now. Which they should be doing. We only see Tracer. They're going after the Night Camp, actually. Alright, so we know that they got their Night Camp. The enemy team still has two level leads on us. We can't really get too... far out from safety here. We need to make sure we're grouping with each other. You see the enemy team here, and if they get stuck by that stun, I might be able to land a kill here. Remember, Shadow Fissure does not deal damage to enemy minions here. Mercenary camps. They were able to stop that. Zul able to get there at the same time. Nice job by ETC landing it. Here comes the stun here. I was able to land that on Leoric as well. There's the pulse bomb from Tracer, but I was able to get the Frost Nova off, and she's going to go down as well. What a great play there by ETC, but more importantly, Zul stopping the cap right in the last, like, millisecond of that happening. What a play. So we get a free boss, and on top of that, we also have our Phylactery done, and we don't have 30 stacks of Blight quite yet. But just like that, we've got ourselves a golden opportunity to take double bosses. It's only Alarak and Abathur that are alive right now. So it was a beautiful sacrifice there by ETC, and man oh man. I'm not going to be able to get out of that. Nicely done by our team here. Again, getting that Phylactery is going to be so nice for these late game team fights as well. I get the Shadow Fissure! Oh, Alarak wasn't paying attention for half a second there. Nice shot by Tyrande throwing out the Sentry Owl. As we see where Abathur is finally, we got him. So 1 second left. Level 20, by the way, I went for Might of the Scourge. So anytime that I land the Shadow Fissure on an opponent, did I completely forget where he was there, or did I just miss? Or did he leave? He may have left. Almost landed the chain there on Leoric. And here comes the Shadow Fissure. It's going to land right on top of Zul'jin. And remember, with Might of the Scourge, I'm able to throw it out for a second time instantaneously anytime that I land it on an enemy hero. 8 seconds left. We have the next tribute going down in the bot lane. I'm fully expecting Abathur to burrow over there, and if he does, I might get Shadow Fissure enough in time to get him. Was able to get him there with one. Here comes another one. Bam! Here comes another one, Abathur. You're not getting away from Kel'Thuzad. Just like that, able to stop him. Tyrande almost got the snipe, but I wasn't paying attention here. Unfortunately, I'm going to die for that, but hey, we almost stopped Abathur. I'm going to go ahead and get right back up here with the Phylactery. I was too excited because I really wanted to kill Abathur right there. That was a needless death. Keeping Abathur honest here, I'm going to grab these two regen globes because why not at this point? Abathur doing a really good job at basically being a nuisance across the entire map here. Ah, okay. Again, not really doing a whole lot of hero damage. I have died more than usual. Well, it's not really more than usual for me with a new hero. It's more than I have been dying with as Kel'Thuzad. Tyrande able to get the snipe with the sentry on Abathur. That's a huge kill. Because that means that we don't have to worry about Abathur for this teamfight. We certainly don't have to worry about him soaking and pushing lanes while we're going to try to press this next advantage here. The Shadow Fissure was good enough to stop Abathur from taking that second tribute. So this is our third one, and that was a... this sets us up here. We're going to get a free regen globe here for the Phylactery. The Phylactery. The Phil's Lactations. I was like, Sinvicta, I don't understand how your brain works sometimes. You know what? I'm Sinvicta, and I still don't know how it works sometimes. So the boss camp going to be up in about a minute and a half. And right now is a good time for us to press the advantage here with a good team fight, especially with Abathur being down. I wasn't going to use Shadow Fissure there. It's a kind of a waste. We need to make sure that we land the chain. That's what we're really looking for. Abathur back up. I'm going to take care of the Toxic Nests here. March of the Black King by Leoric. Who really cares about that? There we go, and here comes the Shadow Fissure spam. There goes one. Here comes another one. Boom, there they go. Here comes another one. Where are you going, Zul'jin? ETC landing the Mosh Pit. Very nicely done. Did not land the chain, unfortunately, on Alarak. Was able to get the Frost Nova, though, and that's a lot of damage. He's going to be taken from me and Jaina. Look at the burst there from Jaina and myself. Huge, huge damage there from me and Jaina. You're sort of getting an idea now. Now that I'm a little bit more warmed up, you're sort of getting an idea of what this build can do in capable hands. Certainly not in my hands. My hands are not capable. We're going to get another regen globe here for the Phylactery. As Kel'Thuzad calls it, Phylactery. There we go. So I do believe that this is the way that Blizzard is looking. It was intending for Kel'Thuzad to be played. I talked about it in yesterday's episode. But with the Glacial Spike, which ironically I haven't had to use all that much in this game, which is really unusual because I'm usually using it nonstop when I played in other games and just the practice games. Rhonda looking for the she actually landed that on Tracer. I think that just happened to be incidental there because she was just checking to see if they were going for the boss. A fateful choice. We should go after these mercenary camps real quick. We don't want to give Abathur a free go on that. And also, keep in mind, I'm still not at 30 stacks on Blight, by the way, which is just absolutely abysmal. At this point in the game, in 22 minutes, this is the longest that I've ever gone without being on 30 stacks of Blight. I will admit that, but this has sort of been a little bit of a substandard game here. I don't usually die this much as Kel'Thuzad, and I certainly don't usually soak this much. I don't know how I'm number one in Siege and on XP. There we go, one more stack with the regen globe for the Phylactery, and then we are going to be able to get our free res. There we go. Just like that, we also get our 10% life leech. We should try to go for the boss or stop them from getting theirs. I think stopping Abathur right now is going to be a pretty big part of us late game fight here. I don't know about that one, Blizzard. I feel like I definitely stopped him before he got out of there. No. We gotta go. Are we gonna go for it? I guess we're gonna go for the boss, alright? I don't suggest ever doing this in the late game, especially. I guess since we're all right here, I still don't suggest doing it. Just don't do this. Don't do what our team is doing right now. Don't take a boss whenever the enemy team has more than one person still alive on the team. Not late game, anyway. Tyrone's gonna die down there to Tracer, and they're gonna be able to get their boss in retaliation.
So be it. I'm returning to town. Whatever it is.
But they do have to defend against our boss that we got. Oh, ETC, you can easily... go ham over here, or go beef over here on Tracer. Nicely done there. I'm not even gonna use Shadow Fissure there. Somehow Abathur was able to kill ETC with a monstrosity. That's not something you see all that often. Still sitting at 29 stacks of blight because it wouldn't be a Sinvicta game if I wasn't playing it somewhat suboptimally, even though it's a build that I've been trying to hamstring and work my own. I mean, not 30 stacks of 25 minutes is standard. I'm going to say it's standard here. I'm netted. Alright. So that's what the net looks like from Zul'jin. I don't think I've ever seen any Zul'jin player take the net. That's alright, because we're back. Back and ready to rock. We really need our team to group up, though. We can get a couple regen globes here to get our phylactery back. That'd be nice. Or not. ETC is back up as well, so... There we go. Ana and I making sure we're on top of those toxic nests here. Apparently, they want to go for the night camp. I'm okay with that.
That sounds logical.
Don't know about the boss, though. I think going for the boss would be a terrible idea. The enemy team, they were able to stop that boss without really losing anything. And let's just see exactly what the enemy team decides to do here. Yeah, here comes Tracer. Looks like she was able to blink just out of there right before I got my chain. I know that Abathur is going to be throwing down a toxic nest, so hopefully somebody's paying attention for that. Looks like they're still chasing after Tracer, which, I mean, if they can get the kill on her, that's great. Oh man, ETC just got knocked out of that mosh pit. I was able to get a Shadow Fissure off anyway and landed it on Alarak. So he ended up getting taken out. And I got the recast as well, which almost killed Zul'jin. Forced it back away. Had ETC landed that mosh pit, man, we were looking pretty darn sharp. Rhonda landing the sentry here. Game's still not over yet. There's one. Gonna go for another one here. We can get the kill on Zul'jin. Just barely missed it. Here comes the net. I'm trying to get away from Zul'jin. Staying alive. That Shadow Fissure saving us. I'm gonna get out of here before Tracer ends up rezzing. We finally got 30 stacks, by the way, which is the reason why that Shadow Fissure did so much more damage to Alarak. But this hard 4-stack, sort of struggling here with the silliness of solo queue, going in a minute 28. This game, crazy game. Guess we're going to get a couple of regen globes up here, and I'm fine with that.
So be it.
There we go. So 28 minutes now, 28 to 28. Very, very close game. Nice shot by ETC. Here we go. Here comes the Shadow Fissure spam. Look how much damage you're able to get off there. You just go in there and spam R. That's all you need to do. I see that Abathur is right here. He's deep burrowing. He's deep tunneling somewhere. I'm not sure if he's going to plan on going into our base or not. Yeah, we'll get another regen globe there. We should definitely... We could push for the win or just go for the boss. The boss will still give us the win. Wonderful job by our ETC player. It's going to be one easy push here as they have a naked core on the bot lane. And that combined with the final tribute here should be it. So again, not really what I would say is a standard game of showing off what this build can do, but you got to see some of the burst here and there. Certainly a lot better than yesterday's, in my opinion, anyway. It's still taking practice. I'm still going to practice more and more of it. I pledge to you all that I will try to be the best that I can with this whole fissure burst combo thing. It is a lot of fun. When you pull it off, it feels really good. It's like pulling off a bad band-aid, man or woman. I don't know what that means. Oh, he got that blink right out of the way. Nicely done. March of the Black King here from Leoric. I threw down the Shadow Fissure anyway because, I mean, hell, why not? Throw down another Shadow Fissure because, I mean, hell, why not? Land the chain. See you later. Got the stun on Tracer, so we're going to be able to get the win here. Final total is going to be 33 to 28. I'll put a link down below to the build. Try it out for yourself. Tell me how you're doing with the Shadow Fissure combo. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Who's MVP? Tyrone's MVP. There you go.